Now that we've understood the satisfiability problem, we're ready to tackle the Cook-Levin theorem. Remember that we have to turn any problem in NP into an instance of SAT. So it's natural to start with the thing that we know all problems in NP have in common. There's a non-deterministic machine that decides them in polynomial time. That's the definition, after all. Therefore, let L be an arbitrary language in NP, and let M be a non-deterministic Turing machine that decides L in time at most P of N, where P is a polynomial. An accepting computation, or sequence of configurations, for the machine M can be represented in a tableau like this one here. Each configuration in the sequence is represented by a row, where we have one column for the state, one column for the head position, and columns for the values of the first P of N squares of the tape. Note that no other squares can be written to, because there just isn't time to move the head that far in only P of N steps. Of course, the first row must represent the initial configuration, and the last one must be in an accepting state in order for the overall computation to be accepting. Note that it's possible that the machine will enter an accepting state before step P of N, but we can just stipulate that when this happens, all the rest of the rows in the table have the same values. This is like having the accept state always transition to itself. The Cook-Levin theorem, then, consists of arguing that the existence of an accepting computation is equivalent to being able to satisfy a CNF formula that captures all the rules for filling out this table.